Hi everyone, good morning. This is Anil K. Sharma and welcome to my channel Oracle Tech India. And today in this video lecture, I will show you how Oracle 12c database software is installed on Windows 7, 8, 9 and 10. So here I have one PDF file in which steps are given to install Oracle 12c database on Windows. So before I start this video lecture, please subscribe my channel. So let's start and try to understand how Oracle software is installed on Windows. So here the heading is installing Oracle 12c. So in the below screen, we have already downloaded setup for Oracle 12c database. So this is your setup for Oracle 12c database. What you have to do is to click on this setup to install Oracle database on your system. So you just click here. Okay, after that you have this kind of screen. So what you have to do, you have to leave this email ID and you have to select this radio button. Okay, you have to click on this option, you have to check it, and then you have to click on the next button, right? Okay, after clicking on the next button, this kind of warning message will be displayed to you. So you just don't worry about it, and you just click on yes button to continue it. Okay, so you have not provided an email address. Do you wish to remain uninformed of critical security issues in your configuration? So you have to go with yes button. You just click here on yes button. So after clicking on yes button, the next screen is like this. So what you have to do here is you have to select skip software updates. This is again the radio button, and you have to check it. You have to select this button, and then you have to click on next button. So after clicking on the next button, the next screen is like this. So here in this screen you have three options. First is create and configure a database. Second is install database software only, and the third is upgrade an existing database. So out of these three options, you have to select the first one, create and configure a database, and then you have to click on the next button, right? Okay, after clicking on the next button, the next screen is like this. So here you have two options, desktop class and the server class. So you have to select this desktop class and then you have to click on the next button, right? Okay, after clicking on the next button, you have this kind of screen. So here in this screen you have to select this option, use Windows built-in account. So you have to select this option, okay, and then you have to click on the next button. You have to click on the next button. So you have to click here. You have to click here on the next button, right? After that, this message will be displayed to you. So don't worry about it. You just go ahead with yes button. So you have to click on this yes button to continue it. Okay. So I just delete it, otherwise it will create problem. So after clicking on yes button, you have this kind of screen, and this screen is very important to understand. Okay, so here we have a lot of options that we need to understand. First is Oracle based. All these fields are automatically selected, so you have to give Oracle based. So this is the Oracle base kind of path and this is automatically selected. Then software location, this is the path of software location where the software will be installed. Database file location, and this is the location where all database files will be installed. Database edition, you have to select this. Character set, you have to select this. And of course you have to give a global database name. So this global database name you will be using when you connect to Oracle database. So this is very important option. Okay, so whatever you can give here as the name, that would be the global database name. Okay, and then you have to give administrative password. Okay, so whatever the password you give here, that would be the password when you connect to your database. Okay, and then you confirm this password, and this option create as container database, this option you have to uncheck it. Okay, this option you have to uncheck it. Okay, and then click on the next button. So let's see what happens in the next slide. So this we have already done, and this we have already selected. We have already given the global database name. We have also provided administrative password, and we have also confirmed it. And create as container database, this we have already unchecked it. Okay, now next we have this kind of a screen. So we have already done with this kind of screen. So in the previous slides we have already done with this screen. So here we have Oracle Base, software location, database file location, database edition, character set, global database name. The name of global database here is ORCL. Whatever you want to give, you can. Okay, it should be ORCL, it should be NetJetPet, whatever you want to give here, you can give. And this is the administrative password. Okay, and then we have clicked on the next button. So the next is next we have this kind of screen. We have to do nothing here, just go ahead. Okay, and then we have the screen like this. This is the summary of Oracle Database 12c release 1 installer. Okay, here what you have to do is, here you have to click on the install button. Okay, here you have to click to install the Oracle software. So after clicking on install button, okay, your software will get started installing, and then you have to go ahead and you have to go ahead and here you have to click on OK button. Right here you just click here OK button. Right, okay, after that you have to go ahead. Okay, and this is the last screen where a message is given that the installation of Oracle Database is successful. The installation of Oracle Database was successful. So this is the screen where you see that your installation of Oracle Database is complete, right? And then you have to click here on close button. So your database is now installed, and then you have to go ahead. And what you have to do the next, that you just click on SQL plus. Okay, so how you would find this SQL plus? So you have to go on this path, go to start button, and then all programs, and Oracle OraDB 12 underscore home 1, and then application development, and there you will find SQL plus, or you can simply see it in your start or all programs. Okay, so whenever you find this SQL plus, you just hit enter button on this SQL plus, and the below kind of screen will be displayed to you. What you have to do here is you just need to give username. So your default username is system, and then you have to give password, and the password that you have provided in the previous slide, administrative password. Okay, so here you need to give administrative password that you have already given in the previous slide, and then you have to hit on enter button, then you will be connected to SQL Plus. Okay, so the next slide will show you that you are now connected to SQL Plus. So let's see the next slide. So here you have the next slide, and this slide shows that you are now connected to SQL Plus. But whenever you connect to Oracle database, you need to give global database name that we have already provided in the previous slide, ORCL. So here in this screen, you are now connected to SQL, and you just write here SQL commands and see the results. So these are the basic steps to install Oracle database. So thank you so much for watching this video.